Hello everyone, for today's devotional we'll be looking at Psalm 107. The topic that I've chosen for today's devotional is Consider God's Steadfast Love. Before we go into the passage, let's look to the Lord in prayer. Our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day that you have added to our lives. As we read these verses and meditate on your word, let your spirit talk to us and let this passage be a blessing to us today and in the coming days. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So if you see Psalm 107, it can be split into different sections. There's an introduction, a conclusion, and in between there are four different sections or stanzas which talk about four different sets of people in various situations. We'll be seeing about these four sets of people in detail. The psalm begins by giving a call to give thanks to the Lord for his steadfast love. And this call is directed towards the redeemed of the Lord, whom he has redeemed from trouble. Next, when we go into the four sections that I talked about, each of the sections will have four subdivisions. There will be a difficult situation, a cry for help, a response from God, and finally, a call to worship and action. So the first section talks about those who wander the wilderness. So here the psalmist talks about some people who wandered in desert ways and they found no way to a city to dwell in. They were wandering the desert or the wilderness and they did not know the path which they had to take to find a safe city to dwell in. In their trouble they cried to the Lord and he delivered them from their distress. He led them by a straight way till they reached a city to dwell in. So this was the wondrous thing that the Lord had done for them. And in response to this, they are called to give thanks to the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wondrous works to the children of man. For he satisfies the longing soul and the hungry soul he fills with good things. The second section talks about those who dwell in darkness. So here, the psalmist talks about some people who sat in darkness and in the shadow of death. They were prisoners in affliction and irons. For they had rebelled against the words of God. They had not listened to the counsel of the Most High, and therefore they were in darkness and in the shadow of death. And in that trouble they cried to the Lord for help, and he delivered them from all their distress. He brought them out of the darkness and the shadow of death and burst their bonds apart. And the response that is expected from them is that they should thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for he shatters the doors of bronze and cuts in two the bars of iron. The third section talks about those who suffer due to sin. The psalmist talks about some people who were fools through their sinful ways, and because of their sins and iniquities they suffered affliction, and they even drew near to the gates of death. In their trouble they called to the Lord for help, and he delivered them from their distress. He sent out his word and healed them. He delivered them from the destruction which was caused because of their sinful ways. And again they are called to give thanks to the Lord for his steadfast love, and they are called to offer sacrifices of thanksgiving and tell of his deeds in songs of joy. The last set of people were those who sailed the seas. So here there are some people who went down to the sea in ships and they did business on the great waters. And there they saw the deeds of the Lord, the wondrous works in the deep. So in these verses, the psalmist talks about how the Lord raised a stormy weather and he showed these people his full might and power. And when they did not know what to do, when they were almost like drowning, they cried to the Lord in their trouble and he delivered them from their distress. He made the storm be still and the waves of the sea were hushed, and he brought them to their desired destination. And again they are called to give thanks to the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wondrous works to the children of man. And they are called to extol him in the congregation of the people and praise him for all the wondrous things and the deliverance that he has given them in the assembly of the elders. At the end, after talking about these four sets of people, the psalmist contemplates for a while on the sovereignty of God. He says that God turns rivers into a desert because of the evil of its inhabitants, and at the same time he turns a desert into pools of water, and there he lets the hungry dwell and he establishes for them a city to live in. And finally, the psalmist gives a call to everyone who is reading this passage. He says, "Whoever is wise, let him attend to these things. Let them consider the steadfast love of the Lord." So, friends, whatever situation we may be in, we may be in the wilderness, we may be in darkness, we may be slaves to sin, or we may be just going about this world's business without bothering about God or anything eternal. In any situation we are called to consider the steadfast love of the Lord, and any time we call to Him for help, He is always there for us. He is always there to rescue us and to remind us of His steadfast love with which He has loved us from the beginning, from creation, and from the beginning of eternity. Let this passage, as we read it, be a blessing to us, and I hope that we all will contemplate on the steadfast love of the Lord with which He has loved us throughout these past days, past years, and let us thank God for all that He has done in our lives.